you know? Yeah. And actually, I'm just tangent on that real quick. So the whole life's over thing. So men attempt to self-select, we'll call it, because if you put this on YouTube, they don't like the S word.
Yeah.
A lot. Yeah. I don't, and it's very annoying because like right. We want to talk about these topics like adults and like they treat it like it's, I don't know, like it's like I'm throwing nudes up or something, but whatever, right. You know,
yep.
A dude takes himself, yep. Right. Self-deletion. Right. And so men are attempting that and succeeding at that 5 more times than women are. And the reason is actually because of our internal wiring. It's really interesting. It's that we're designed to be what I call useful chimps as men, meaning we, as our evolutionary past, we got the resources or protected the resources. And so if we don't feel useful or valuable, and that includes reproductively valuable, then there's a tendency to want to self-delete to allow for resources to be available for the rest of the tribe and the children of the tribe. And so self-deletion or self-sacrifice is a very male concept. Women generally don't do that unless it's for their direct children. And I'm not saying that a woman isn't a human being and can use her frontal lobe and decide to do that, but on an instinctual level, she doesn't. And this is why guys tend to take the more dangerous jobs. Why guys tend to, it's not social conditioning and we're trying to keep women down and all that bull crap. It's because women do not want to do a job where they could go get killed. And men will volunteer for those jobs for, well, there's idealism and stuff we tell ourselves, but the instinctual reason is sexual access. And if we end up deleting ourselves for the good of the tribe, that seems to be okay in our wiring system.
Yeah.
You know, so yeah. And so that's just something to keep in mind. So like when a girl says you're no longer reproductively valuable because she's going to cheat on you with Tyrone or Chad or whatever, like now you're like that signal in the brain is going, oh, you're not reproductively valuable. You should probably go, you know, self-delete now.
Yep.
It's a signal, dude. It happens to most guys and they're not wanting to admit it because they don't want someone to say, oh God, cry for help, you know, call somebody, lock them up. But it's the reality is those thoughts happen for most guys in those moments in certain times and they don't feel valuable. And they have to understand, of course, we need to accept that just an instinctual drive. And that thought is just a real dark thought that we don't want to act on or do anything about, like in a bad way. You don't want to do a permanent solution to a temporary problem.
Yep.
But those feelings without anyone having that discussion, man, guy will get those feelings, think that those are as real as rain, right. And then they might do something.
Exactly. That's not good. No, yeah. You're right. And I think, yep. Like you said, the statistics back that up. You mentioned 5 times more likely in general. I think that goes up to 9 times as likely after a divorce, right? I think post-divorce men are 9 times more likely to self-delete than a woman is.